Stress, also known as physical and emotional tension, is generally considered a negative, especially as it pertains to our performance. But the existing research on stress is ambiguous and contradictory. Though there is plenty of evidence to support that in excess, stress can have negative effects on things like attention and decision-making, other research shows positive effects to a certain extent. The stress performance curve unifies these contradictions. This familiar-looking curve was developed back in 1908. It shows how a little bit of stress serves to keep you engaged in a task, and performance increases. To a point. Higher levels of stress on the right side of the curve progress beyond a threshold, eventually causing performance to decline. The assessments the human brain makes about stressful situations are extremely subjective, not as objective or analytical as we might hope. Let's narrow in on a definition of stress for the purposes of this course. According to Driscoll and Salas, the term stress describes a process by which environmental demands, for example, time pressure, novel or threatening events, and noise, evoke an appraisal process in which perceived demand exceeds resources and results in undesirable physiological, psychological, behavioral, or social outcomes. Physical variables, number of patients, level of instability, equipment malfunction, and internal factors, coping style, level of fatigue, sense of control, and self-confidence also change the assessment. Internal factors play a key role in our ability to adapt and respond. Training to enhance these factors can in turn alter how we assess and respond to future stressful encounters. By cultivating these internal factors, we can train ourselves to better handle significant stress. Our training for acute stress management covers two basic components over a handful of modules. The first will improve your familiarity with the unique features, emotions, and sensations associated with acute stress. The second will help you incorporate simple psychological skills designed to control stress and improve performance at the individual level. It is important to realize that your response to stress is something you've developed through a lifetime of personal experiences. Unlearning these reactive tendencies will not be easy. It will take your active participation in this course and continued practice of the strategies you will learn. Thank you for joining me. Now that we know what stress is, we're ready to learn more about the effects of acute stress.